basketball is really played to a beat.
The music has really made an impact.
I think the element of hip hop, as far as personally, it gets me hyped.
Music is great, and I try to use it to my best interest to really kind of get myself loose.
Certain song come on, and you're just there bobbing your head to it, you know, it seems to get you going.
The New York Knicks have taken their love for hip-hop a step further. As per their request, the first song played during warm-ups at home games is Redman's Time for Some Action. Time for some action.
No, we're from Utah now, so we ain't gonna be playing no hardcore stuff. But we're going to other arenas, and it's be really nice in other arenas. And you start to say to yourself, God, you know, why we can't have this tape to warm up with?
Some players who are hip-hop fans even enjoy listening to records recorded by their competition.
I'm outstanding.
Yeah, we listen to Shaq, even though, you know, it's personal on the court, but we listen to him. He got a nice album. We listen to him. I don't know if Patrick listened to it.
I wanted to get your critique of Shaquille O'Neal's album.
I really haven't listened to it.
My rap album will be out. I'll be with Shaquille on an album. In fact, we'll be touring next summer. I'm not sure if Shaquille is aware of this, but his people will be informing him of that very shortly.
So you'll be known as Marv Foo?
It's going to be simply Shaq and Marv. There you have it.
That's not true, Mark.
In the 90s, hip-hop has slowly made its way onto the NBA playlist, but you won't hear much of it after tip-off. The majority of songs played at arenas nationwide is old-time party rock and roll.
The core songs are the same. You're still going to find that toga rock, that frat rock kind of thing, that Wooly Bully and Louie Louie and Moni Moni and all those kind of numbers. And of course, in Rock and Roll Part 2, which is kind of the arena national anthem at this point.
And some find the artistic expression which fuels rock and hip-hop is very similar to the passion expressed on the court.
Our fans get a big thrill when athletes go up and like make a big slam dunk, and it's the same as when, say, a guitar player makes a solo on his album and he's really getting talent on the guitar, so, or a rapper just comes out and freestyles.
A lot of guys, when you see their moves, their acrobatic moves, they're moves of ballet, they're hard, aggressive moves of hip-hop. So, I mean, it music and what we do in sports, they're combined. I mean, they're together. There is one.